Hey everyone, Nick here, and today I'm going to show you how to make this really cool countdown effect in your PowerPoint slides, and we're not going to use any slide animations at all. It's all using the Morph transition, which you should have in Microsoft 365 versions. So you've probably been in situations where you wanted to have a countdown or some sort of a timer on your slides, and here's one of the ways that you can do it. So here's kind of a countdown for 10 seconds, and I'll show you what it looks like right now. Click over here. Pretty cool, huh? It's just 1 second a slide, 10, 9, 8, kind of a cool countdown. You could use this in different presentations in different contexts and different sort of workshop settings and things like that. Think about a 60-second timer, maybe a 2-minute timer. You could do the same technique with this. So that was 1 second per sort of slide, but we can also do this in kind of more of a sped up version. And here's that. Here's what that looks like on the slide. 10 all the way to 1. And that's just made up of 2 slides and 1 morph transition. So I'm going to show you how to do that right now. We're going to escape out of this and we're going to go ahead and make our version from scratch over here. The first thing I'm going to do is insert a brand new slide. I'm just going to use the blank layout right here. I'm going to go ahead and look at all my other the other slides that I have here. Those are my demonstration slides. I'm going to go ahead and select them all, and then I'm going to hide them all. That's another trick. When you hide a slide like this, you can see it on your end in the normal view, but when you view it in slideshow mode, nobody will be able to see it. And the same goes for saving it as a PDF or something like that. They won't be able to see the hidden slides. So here's one slide that we have right now. I'm going to go ahead and insert a text box. So let's go ahead and insert this text box, and I'm going to go ahead and type 10. We're going to do that 10 countdown here. We're going to go ahead and make this be the font that I want. I like this Open Sans extra bold. That's pretty nice. I'm going to go ahead and change it to my blue color. I'm going to make this centered. And then what I'm actually going to do is we need to go ahead and increase the size so it really fills the slide. So I think we're going to go all the way up. We can actually just do this if we want to do it. I'm going to make sure everything is centered. Doesn't really matter how this is centered because we're going to do some other things after this. Now stay on the exact same slide because what we're going to do is we're going to add a couple elements to the slide that we're then going to duplicate the slide. So everything that we put on this first slide has to stay on all of the other slides here. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a rectangle and I'm just going to put it right at the top like this. And then I'm going to Control D to duplicate this. So we'll have another one. And I think that looks pretty good. This one I might want, actually I'll just put the text box just a little bit down more so it's kind of in the middle of those. That looks pretty nice. And now what I want to do is actually just turn both of these boxes white. So I'm going to highlight both of them and we're going to go ahead up to the shape fill and make them white and make sure there's no outline involved. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going, with both of them selected, we're going to make sure that these boxes are moved up to the front. We don't want them to be on the back layer, we want them to be on the front layer. So I'm going to right click when both of them are selected and say bring to front. This is going to put both of the boxes in front, and it's going to put the text box behind those two white rectangles. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead with this 10, I'm going to push enter, and I'm going to push 9. Now you can see that I typed the 9, but it's actually kind of hidden behind that white box. So you can kind of see where I'm going here. We're actually going to go ahead and just do 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now I just have this one giant, and then I'm going to leave an extra space at the bottom. So I'm going to push enter so that there's kind of a return right here, and there's just a blank space right there. So now what we need to do is I'm going to zoom out. So I'm going to go down here to the bottom left, the zoom out, and I'm just going to zoom all the way out so you can really get a bird's eye view of this slide. And actually I want it to be even less than that, I think. Perfect. So it's really tiny right here, but this kind of helps. This is going to help you to sort of orient the slide and orient the countdown to where you want the numbers to be. All right. So everything is on this slide. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Make sure you got all your numbers correct. And now what we're going to do is go up to the transitions tab and we're going to apply the morph transition. Just say morph right here. Perfect. And I'm going to go ahead and just keep over here over the timing options. I'm actually going to reduce the timing to 1 second because I want it to be 1 second per number here, kind of a 10 second countdown. Now I'm also going to keep this on mouse click. Now the very next slide, I'm going to change this and I'm going to select after because I want it to continue on its own. I just want to be able to click one time and have the entire transition, the entire group of transitions perform on its own. So we're going to keep this for now. Now let's go ahead and duplicate this slide. We're going to push Control D and it's going to duplicate that slide and everything on it. And now it's still in this bird's eye view. Now all I'm going to do is I'm just going to nudge this up, the text box up. So instead of 10, I'm going to go ahead and move it up with the up arrow so that 9 is now in the center of my slide. So now what we're going to do, the morph transition is still applied, my transitions tab is right here. I'm going to go ahead and uncheck on mouse click and click after. And what this is going to do is it's going, and you can see here the timing is set to 0 seconds, 0 minutes, 0 seconds. So what it's going to do is it's just going to play this transition, play the next slide after the previous slide. And so we want it to do that on its own. We don't want to have to click every single time we want the slide to transition. So let's just go ahead to the first slide and play it in slideshow mode so that we can see what it looks like, okay? The first two slides anyway. All right, so remember, you have to click once or push the over arrow to activate the first slide and it should scroll up to 9. Perfect, so that was my last slide. So now all I have to do is go through this process 8 more times and we're gonna move the text box up every single time. So let's go ahead and Control D this slide. So now we need this to be at 8. So I'm gonna go ahead and move that up. Control D, move it up to 7. This is when you need to put on the music because these are just sort of the repetitive tasks that you do. I'm going to go ahead and do this. You can also, a trick I like to do is look over here on your left in the slide sorter view, and you can get a bird's eye view of what that slide is going to look like. So I kind of like looking at that as well when I'm designing my slides. We're going to put this up to 5. Oops, I actually duplicated the text box, not the slide. So make sure that this slide is highlighted in your slide sorter, Control D. Now we'll go up to 4. Perfect. Oop, I can see that 3 poking out just a little bit, so I'm going to go ahead and nudge that down. Perfect. And Control D again. Almost done here. We're going to go up to 3. Then 2. The cool thing about everything around the slide in PowerPoint, this is all called the pasteboard around the slide. You can put as many objects and pictures on that pasteboard as you want to, and nobody will see it when you're in slideshow mode. So that's one of the reasons why I like PowerPoint too. You can kind of keep all these assets off to the side if you want to. Oops, I'm going to go ahead and click the text box, move it just down a little bit. Perfect. Click the slide, Control D, a couple more times. We're going to nudge this up to 1. And one more time just so that we leave it blank. And that'll be the last one. Awesome. This looks pretty good. Let's go back up to the top and play it in slideshow mode and see what it looks like. Slideshow mode here. Then we're going to have to click once. And now it'll start going on its own. A perfect countdown. And doesn't it look cool? Those two white boxes really give that a really interesting effect. You could do this without the white boxes, but I just really like the way that it feels like those numbers are kind of disappearing into the countdown. Now I said that we might do that other layer of countdown. So let's actually go ahead and just copy this slide one more time. I'm going to duplicate this slide. And instead of on 1, I'm going to move this all the way down to 10 here. And then we're going to copy this one more time, duplicate, and now I'm going to move the text box all the way to 1. So with the morph transition, you just want to end the slide or end the object on the, you place the object into the position that you want it to end on that slide. So instead of 10 different slides, each counting down one after another, this is just going to be 2 slides, and it's going to go from 10, and it's going to scroll all the way up to 1. So let's go ahead and see if this works. This should just be actually an automatic. So let's go ahead and put this on mouse click. We will say after there, and I'm going to go ahead and put it in slideshow mode. Now I'm going to click this once, and it should just scroll all the way up to 1. Yep. Perfect. There we go. And that was it had the other slide on the end of it. So, but you can see how that really works, and that actually looks really, really cool. Let me see it one more time. I'm going to play this. I deleted that final slide there, so we'll see if it actually works. Click. Down to one. Perfect. Now, if I wanted that to stay on one, you can see that it went to black right away because there's no slides after. All the slides afterwards are hidden. All you would need to do is say, I think we could actually just leave. Let's see if we do the duration. The duration actually might have to do with how fast the morph goes. So we might just have to click on, we might just have to say on mouse click for it to end. Let's keep this at 125. We're going to change that last slide to on mouse click. If you just have two slides, that might be the way to do it. We're going to go back to number 10, play it in slideshow mode. I'm going to click. And then it stays there. So that's pretty good. So if you have a transition or a final slide, that's a really good thing to know. Just make sure you point this to on click instead of afterwards, and it won't just go black on you. It won't just go to blank screen. It'll be a perfect countdown timer for you. So I hope that you use this trick in one of your next presentations. I'm going to go ahead and make another couple cool animations of this, kind of like I'm thinking of sort of like a battery, like a phone battery countdown as these are counting down. And I think we could do that mixing some animations and some of these morph transitions. And then the really cool thing is you could export this to a video or to a GIF. So if you didn't want to include all of those slides in your slide deck, you could actually just export this as a GIF file or as a GIF file. I guess it's pronounced GIF, not GIF. And you could just add that right into your slide. And when you play it in slideshow mode, the countdown GIF is going to just move that countdown throughout the presentation, which would be pretty cool. So I hope you give it a try. Let me know how you use this in the comments. If you like this video, I hope you'll give it a thumbs up and definitely hit subscribe and the bell next to it to get notified every time I post a new video in data design, PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Remember, you don't need to be a professional designer to look like one using the software that you already use and have access to every single day. I hope you all have a great day, and I will see you next time.